Yeah, sure.
Just a quick thoughts about the match. It wasn't the kind of start you would have hoped to have.
Yeah, it was very tough match in general. I was feeling very tight, very nervous. It could be for many different reasons, but that was the case. And when it's like this, it's tougher to play, because usually I'm not. Usually I come in and it's a different nerve, the nerve that I'm used to. This one was kind of new. Straight away after I lost, I missed some shots. I look at my my team, I start whining, and that's when it's probably not going to be good. But at one moment I managed to gather myself together. Finally didn't lose my serve after that moment. Yeah, in general, happy to win, even in tough conditions. Sometimes you need to do it like this. If I want to win next matches, I have to be better. But win is a win.
We'll just go with English first and then we'll talk to Russia.
Daniil, congrats. A little bit before you stepped on court, the announcement was made between the ATP and the PIF. Did you know?
No. Okay. What is PIF?
The Saudi Private Investment Fund.
Uh-huh.
So
Okay.
It's a big partnership.
Yeah.
Just curious, what is your reaction?
Well, to be honest, no reaction at the moment, because, well, before was Emirates, then Pepperstone, then what else do we have? Like, I don't even know. Who are the main, like, sponsors? I think Peugeot was there for a long time. Like, anyway. Anyway, whoever it is, so it's a new company that you know how sponsorships work. They pay money. ATP decides if they want to promote them, and that's it. I have nothing to do with this decision. So I cannot say more. And also, I didn't know the company or the fund or PIF. Yeah.
So basically, my follow-up would be that there's going to be a big influx of money into the tour because of our changing partnership. It's not one thing.
I think this is good for tennis, you know. It has nothing to do with Saudi, to be honest, because you know, we love our sport, and the more money we can attract from different companies or stuff like this, the more attention, PR we can bring, the more, I don't know, as you said, it's going to be bigger than just sponsorship. So I think if we can make tennis bigger as a sport and more interesting for people, have more coverage, just in general, more people will know tennis, who tennis players are, even if sometimes, you know, maybe you want to be less famous. But yeah, it's going to be good, I think. Yeah, well, first of all, I try to not, like, discuss too much, you know, what's said in the media, and then but I heard him talking to someone French, and they were asking him this question, and he was like, I don't know where they took 16. He said they could say 32, 18, 21. He didn't say 16. That's how sometimes things are. So it was more, I would say, other Gilles Cervara who gave him that list, because me, you know, it's tough to play against everyone, and at the same time it's easy to play against everyone, and Gilles, who's with me for 10 years, he can see more who is troubling more on the court for different reasons. So he gave this list to Gilles. I doubt it was 16 players. I would think it would be less. And then we didn't yet discuss too much. So when I'm going to play one of these players, then we're going to discuss. And now before every match, we discuss the tactics. And I will not talk one by one. You know, Lorenzo is a tough opponent. As we could see today, he turns around the forehand sometimes on the balls where he shouldn't maybe, and then he makes a winner. So you start to think, do I force on the backhand? Do I start to surprise him on the forehand? So yeah, it's not easy to play against anyone.
Mm-hmm. Could you share some of your fondest memories with
My memories. Well, first of all, he's a fun guy and a great guy to be around. So that's always, you know, that's always a great quality in life, I think. Then for sure, he's an admiration of mine, because I remember when I was just going up the rankings, that was a moment where he was winning slams, playing finals and stuff like this against Novak, Roger and Rafa, so the big four. So it's going to be sad when he retires, but you know, he's such a warrior that I think he's going to try to go very far, and even I'm definitely not sure that he's going to stop this year, unless, you know, Wimbledon is a big tournament, unless he decides, you know, I want to Wimbledon and stop. That's a different story. So till he's here, it's going to be fun. When he's not here, I'm sure he's going to find a good good spot in his life after tennis. Thank you. Well, it's very tough always to answer this question, because after you play last year Dubai, then you have like 10 more hardcore tournaments where sometimes it's slower, sometimes it's faster. And I would say it's not brutally fast, otherwise you would definitely remember, like for example, Turin, I can tell you right now, very fast. but Dubai last year, it felt fast, but playable. And I think it's kind of the same, you know, you still have rallies. I lost my serve two times, he lost his three, I think, so. Still, you can break, but then there are some also tie breaks. So I think, in my opinion, for hardcore tennis, it's a great court, not too fast, not too slow. So I like it, yeah. Раньше помогало, сейчас, мне кажется, мешает, когда негативно, поэтому я, в принципе, постарался как бы в этом году поставить себе цель и задачу изменить это, больше фокусироваться на себе, на теннисе, так сказать, убирать этот шум извне. Но вот сегодня как раз-таки не получилось, это, ну, было связано только со мной, то есть я, когда вышел на корт, почему-то неважно себя чувствовал, нервничал, не было концентрации, из-за этого были ошибки, и из-за этого пошла нервозность этот раз против моей команды, и это нехорошо. Я хочу от этого избавиться, иногда не получается, но я буду стараться. Ну, я в приставку играю до сих пор в Радугу, Rainbow Six, и даже вот сейчас из-за того, что чуть было время после Австралии, к сожалению, из-за травмы выбил, ну, мало кто будет знать, но чемпион рейтинг, поэтому очень доволен был. Это такой, это тяжелый рейтинг на самом деле. А так, после матча одна и та же рутина, что там помыться, там может лед где-то подержать, где болит, покушать, сходить к физио, и сон, еда – это два самых главных важных фактора, поэтому… Сейчас, как только выйду, сразу как можно быстрее все сделать и ложиться спать. Но, в принципе, когда ты не играешь 5 сетов, обычно, какой бы матч ни был, ты успеваешь восстанавливаться.
В России будет FIFA своя какая-то,
да? Не, я не слышал. Прикольно, если получится. А то делали многие, получалось не у всех, поэтому если получится, будет прикольно. Но я FIFA, если честно, очень давно не играл. Но я уверен, что мышечная память какая-то осталась. Если что, можно будет что-нибудь придумать.
Спасибо.
Thank you, everyone.